Central Park is not just a park, but it's actually a way of life. This huge green space is right in the middle of Manhattan between the Upper West Side and the Upper East Side. And honestly, I think the city is so lucky to have this beautiful green lung right in the middle of Manhattan. What is really unique about Central Park is that all around the park, you see the buildings of Manhattan, the tall skyscrapers, and right in the middle, you have this huge green space. So Central Park is actually not the biggest park in New York. It's the fifth largest park, but still kafi bada hai. It's about 10 kilometers long, and there are acres and acres of area inside, and there are about 7 different lakes. So this video is going to be all about Central Park, how to reach, what to do here, how much it costs, what all are the must-sees. And also stay tuned, because throughout the video I'll be sharing the different points or the different spots in Central Park which are absolutely Instagram worthy and where you can get great pictures. So let's get going. Start with how to reach Central Park. Now, Central Park is in Uptown Manhattan, like I said, between the Upper West Side and the Upper East Side, and this area is very well connected by the subway. So there are different subway stations around Central Park, and you can easily, if you're in the city, you can easily take a subway and reach here. So how much does it cost to come here? Now the best thing about Central Park is that it's absolutely free. This is a public park and there is no entry fee to come to Central Park, and it's open to everybody. In fact, it's crazy how many people come here. So last year, annually, there were 43 million people who came to Central Park, and 70% of them were local New Yorkers. So clearly this is a favorite among the local people of New York. So next we're going to talk about the things to do in Central Park. The number one thing, take a stroll. So Central Park is very good to come here immediately after lunch or immediately after brunch or breakfast, and you can spend about 2 to 3 hours strolling around here, taking in the sun and just enjoying nature. If you're not planning to visit Central Park, I would suggest to keep at least 2 to 3 hours, because the park is kafi bada hai, and you will be entering from one side and exiting from the other side. So for today's example, we have entered from the west side and we're going to exit from the east side. So another way to explore Central Park is by taking a horse carriage ride, and they take you around the entire park, but it's a little expensive. It'll cost you about $50. A much cheaper option is to rent a cycle or a rickshaw like this, where you can pay per minute, and this is also a little on the pricier side. It costs you about $5 per minute, but if you cannot walk or if you're too tired and you still want to see the park, then this is a good option. So behind me is the second most popular area in Central Park, and this is called the Sheep Meadow. And this place that you see right now is absolutely empty and it's actually locked. But during the summer time, yahan pe itni bheed hoti hai ki you literally don't get a place to sit. And why is that? Because this is the picnic area in Central Park. And during the summer, you can come here, get your own blanket, get your own chadar, get food and have a little picnic. This fountain and that arch, these are very, very popular spots. You can spot this in Kal Ho Na Ho and also in a lot of English movies and TV series. FYI, there's a restroom behind that arch in case you're looking for one here in Central Park. This is one of the lakes in Central Park, and right now it's Jan and there's actually a layer of ice on the lake. Come on. Wow, it is. So behind me is a lake where you can do boating in Central Park, and it's actually a pretty popular activity here. And it costs $15 per hour, and there's also a deposit involved which you get back once you return the boat. But right now, since it's winter and the lake is actually frozen, there's a thin layer of ice on the lake, boating is not happening. But if you come during the summer, or I think even during the fall season, you can definitely do a round of boating in Central Park. Another thing which you need to do in Central Park is to sit on a bench or even on a rock, like the people behind me are sitting, and just do a little bit of people watching, or you know, just chill and relax. And there's actually a very interesting trivia about the bench. Each of these bench has a name of a person written on it, because all benches have been donated by somebody.